Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning, taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Estep, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Dead Money. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Isaiah 55 verse 2. It says, "Why spend money on what is not bread, and your labor on what does not satisfy? Listen to me, and eat what is good, and you will delight in the riches of fare." Children, I wonder how many juniors know what dead money is. This term has a specific meaning to bankers. You might like to call it forgotten money. In one recent year, there was more than $50 million in the banks of America that they called dead money. These $50 million were in more than 2 million accounts. That would mean less than $25 as an average in each account. There were doubtless many accounts with less than $25, but there were doubtless some accounts with much larger sums. Many of these owners had probably died or forgotten about the accounts, so it's called dead or forgotten money. When we visited Pompeii in Italy, they told us about the tragedies that took place when Mount Vesuvius exploded and buried the city under some 20 feet of hot, burning ashes. One dead man was dug out of the ruins in the same position as when the lava and ashes had buried him. When they dug him out, gold coins fell out of his long, bony fingers. What pathetic pictures, a man clutching gold as he died. There are many people in this world who are clutching that money. There are people who are spiritually dead. Paul speaks of this when he writes, "She that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth." 1 Timothy 5 verse 6. So, there are dead lives as well, dead money. Children, all this poses some serious questions. Do I have any dead money? Or is my money alive and working for the Lord and His cause and kingdom? Do I have any unused talents? The talent that the one talent man buried in the earth proved a curse to him. It was taken from him and given to the man who had used his talents. Let us not bury our talent in the earth, which is soon to pass away. We are to lay up our treasures in heaven, where moths and rust do not destroy, or where thieves do not break in and steal. Children, how much that money will there be when Jesus comes? How many debt letters will there be? Let's deliver God's message. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, the questions are, do I have debt money? And how much is it? How much money did you forget? Then, a similar question, how many talents do you have? Are you aware of them? And then, have you used them well? Children, a message for us this morning. Use the talent given to you, even if it's just one. Use it for God's work, to witness the love of Jesus, to give hope to many people. Children, one last question. Do I have a talent that I'm not using? May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.